I woke up at 4 a.m. That's too early.
It is.
Good morning. Previously, we learned a lot about this LR circuit.
Flippin' physics.
However, Bo still has a question. Bo, what is that question?
What does it even mean that we have an equation for the derivative of current as a function of time? As a function of time.
What?
Yeah, what does an equation for the time rate of change of current as a function of time mean?
Sure, that is a fair question. So, you can consider the derivative of current with respect to time to be the electrical equivalent of acceleration for objects in motion.
Okay.
So, current is in amps, and amps are coulombs per second, and velocity is in meters per second. So current in a circuit is like velocity for a moving object.
Okay.
Sure.
And the derivative of velocity with respect to time is acceleration. Acceleration has units of meters per second squared. The derivative of current with respect to time has units of coulombs per second squared. So the derivative of current with respect to time for a circuit is like acceleration for a moving object.
Okay. So at the very beginning, the time rate of change of current is at its maximum value because the current is experiencing its greatest change with respect to time. The slope of current with respect to time has its greatest magnitude.
And at the very end, the current is not changing, so the time rate of change of current as a function of time is zero. The slope of current as a function of time is zero.
And these graphs are exactly the same as the graphs for velocity and acceleration as a function of time for a dropped object, which experiences a drag force.
Whoa. OMG, you are absolutely right. The shape of the velocity curve is exactly the same as the current curve, and the shape of the acceleration curve is exactly the same as the time rate of change of current curve. So, at the very beginning, the acceleration of the object in motion is at its maximum value because its velocity is experiencing its greatest change with respect to time. The slope of velocity with respect to time has its greatest value.
And at the very end, the velocity of the object in motion is not changing, so the acceleration of the object is zero. The slope of the velocity with respect to time is zero. I get it, Mr. P. That is what you meant when you said that we can consider the derivative of current with respect to time to be the electrical circuit equivalent of acceleration for objects in motion. That is cool. Trust me.
Yeah.
I know it's cool. And for the record, I just recycled the same graphs from my lesson deriving motion equations with drag force and my lessons about RC circuits, because they're all the same graphs. I just changed the labels on the vertical axes and the limits. Otherwise, same graphs.
Strange man.
You know what? We've gone this far. Let's take the analogy just a bit further.
Absolutely.
Sure.
Looking at the LR circuit, the equation we started with was 0 equals EMF minus electric potential difference across the resistor minus electric potential difference across the inductor. Looking at an object released from rest and including air resistance, as the object falls, the force of gravity is down and the force of drag is up. In other words, the net force in the y direction on the object equals, taking the down direction to be positive, force of gravity minus the force of drag. And the net force in the y direction also equals mass times acceleration in the y direction. And we can rearrange that equation to get 0 equals the force of gravity minus the drag force minus mass times acceleration in the y direction. So the EMF is analogous to the force of gravity. Both are constant values which are attempting to cause changes in the respective systems. EMF is attempting to change current. Force of gravity is attempting to change velocity. The electric potential difference across the resistor is analogous to the drag force. Both are dissipating energy from their respective systems. The resistor is converting electric potential energy to heat, and the drag force is converting gravitational potential energy to heat. The electric potential difference across the inductor is analogous to mass times acceleration. When we substitute inductance times the derivative of current with respect to time in for the electric potential difference across the inductor, and the derivative of velocity with respect to time in for acceleration, you can see that inductance is analogous to mass. Inductance opposes changes in current, mass opposes changes in velocity. Because mass is a quantitative measure of inertia, and inertia is the tendency of an object to resist acceleration. And the derivative of current with respect to time is analogous to the derivative of velocity with respect to time, or acceleration, which is what I meant when I said we can consider the derivative of current with respect to time to be the electrical circuit equivalent of acceleration for objects in motion.
Oh.
The units don't match up, though. Electrical potential differences in volts, which are joules per coulomb, and joules are newtons times meters, so electric potential difference is in newton meters per coulomb. However, force is just in newtons.
Right. I said it's an analogy. The units don't match, however, their behaviors do.
Okay, sure.
Okay.
Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.